August 9, 1945. An American B-29 bomber flew over the Japanese city Nagasaki at an altitude of 31,000 feet. The bomber was carrying a payload of nuclear bomb, codenamed the FATMAN. At 11 a.m. the bay doors opened, and bomb was dropped. After 43 seconds and 500 meters from the ground, the bomb exploded. This is the second nuclear bomb used by the USA. The first one dropped on Hiroshima was called as Little Boy. Little Boy is a failure compared to the FATMAN. With Little Boy, only 15 kilotons of energy is released, whereas FATMAN released 21 kilotons of energy with 10 times less fission material. Dr. J. Robert Oppenheimer was one of the lead scientists who developed these atomic bombs. The dimensions of FATMAN are 3.3 meters in length, 1.5 meters in diameter, and it weighs nearly 4,670 kilograms. There are two outer metal layers covering the main physics package. At the center of the physics package there is a plutonium-239 sphere. It is about 9.2 centimeters in diameter. This is the main material for nuclear fission process. This is a stable plutonium atom. When this atom got struck by a neutron, it becomes unstable and splits into two small atoms, zirconium and xenon. And also neutrons and energy is released during this process. This splitting of atom is called as nuclear fission. These neutrons again strike the other plutonium atoms. These atoms again get split and neutrons are released. This chain reaction continues, releasing huge amount of energy. So the question arises, how can we have the initial neutrons? Inside the plutonium sphere there is a neutron initiator, made of polonium and beryllium. The polonium is in shape of a sea urchin with spikes around it, and it emits alpha particles. There is a beryllium shell and a pellet, which absorbs these alpha particles and releases neutrons. Covering plutonium, there is a layer of uranium-238. It reflects the neutrons back into the plutonium. But when fast neutron strikes it, uranium-238 also undergoes fission process. It makes up to 30% of total explosion energy. Plutonium and uranium together forms the fission core, and it is just as big as a football. Upon that there is a thin layer of boron plastic sheath. It absorbs slow-moving neutrons and prevents pre-detonation. Then an aluminium layer covers this. It is of 470 millimeters in diameter. And 32 explosive blocks cover this whole arrangement. But why do we need these explosives? In the plutonium sphere, when the space between atoms is more, chain reaction slowly dissipates and fission process stops. When the chain reaction cannot be sustained, plutonium is said to be at subcritical mass. To prevent this, the atoms should be brought closer to each other, or in other terms, the density should be increased. Now the chain reaction can sustain itself, and plutonium is said to be at supercritical mass. To achieve supercritical mass of plutonium, explosives are placed around the plutonium and triggered. The explosion compresses the plutonium and makes it supercritical. Each block is 662 millimeters in length and weighed nearly 75 kilograms. It is divided into two layers, the inner booster layer and the outer explosive lens layer. The inner layer is made of only fast explosives, but outer layer is a combination of fast and slower explosives. So, what is explosive lens and why it is so important? When faster explosives are triggered, it creates a convex shape explosion wave. The converging explosion waves causes unsymmetrical compression of the plutonium sphere. To prevent it, a layer of explosive lens is added. After triggering explosive lens, as the explosion reaches slower explosive, the explosion wave changes from convex to concave in shape. This helps in ensuring that the plutonium sphere is symmetrically compressed. An EBW, or exploding bridge wire detonator, is placed in each block, and a duraluminium case covers this whole arrangement. Here comes the X unit. It provides high voltage current to the EBWs. It is high voltage batteries and capacitors. Wires are connected from these batteries to the 64 terminals. From these terminals, insulated wires are connected to the EBWs. A support structure connects the X unit to the duraluminium case. On the other side there are timers and barra switches. Then we have an Archie radar unit, which operates at 420 MHz. Then we have an APS-13 antenna, with director, radiator, and a reflector. Four antennas like this are connected to the radar unit. And lastly, a steel casing shell encompasses this whole package. On August 8, 1945, President Truman gave permission to drop the second atomic bomb. An asphalt sealant was applied around the casing seams, and it was loaded into the B-29 bomber named Boxcar. The bomber left from Tinian Island at 2:47 a.m. in the morning to the primary target Kokura, but it was completely covered with smoke and clouds. The bomber then turned around to secondary target Nagasaki. At 11 a.m. the bomb was dropped. It had a free fall of 43 seconds. At 500 meters from ground, antenna gave a signal to the Archie radar. It then triggered the X unit. High voltage current is released from batteries to the terminals, then to EBWs. EBWs ignited each explosive block, which set off an implosion shockwave. The shockwave started compressing the aluminium layer. Aluminium layer reduced the turbulence and helped in uniform compression. The inner layers then started getting compressed. Inside the plutonium, as the neutron initiator is getting compressed, the polonium spikes pierce the beryllium and neutrons are released, which set off the fission process. The neutrons are getting smashed into plutonium atoms, and the number of neutrons are getting multiplied exponentially. The intensity of chain reaction has started to increase. Energy released with each fission of atom has started adding up. A total of 21 kilotons of energy is released in the blink of an eye. The fireball expanded up to 15 square kilometers. Up to 760 meters from center, everything is incinerated. Under 2.2 kilometers, everyone had third-degree burns. There were up to 70,000 casualties due to explosion and radiation. These are the before and after pictures of Nagasaki.